I found love in you. And I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. I found love in you. And no other love will do. Every moment that you smile chases all the pain away. Forever and a while, in my heart is where you'll stay. And this is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Oh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. The stars have all aligned, and right now is the perfect time to say, I love you, 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 I do. This is why I love you. This is why I love you. Because you love me. I found love in you, and no other love will do. That's why I love you.
I'm the mom, by the way, not the girl.
Three small grandkids. Rock! broke.
Uh-oh. I don't know, money short now. $26,298,720 minutes of who can cook the best? I don't know.
J-Bo can grill, but Margaret can. Oh, those pots and pans.
Okay.
1,577,923,200 seconds of countless memories of a true Eastside love story.
Today, we celebrate the love of two of the greatest people on this planet we call Mom and Dad. On a hot June day in 1967, right around the corner on Gayard Street, these two started dating with a little help from the late Alton Wingate. Y'all know him, right? Yeah, good old Al. Shout out to Alton.
Woo-hoo.
On September 23rd in 1972, together, your love and life made one. You both have given us life, love, and a home full of valuable memories we won't ever forget.
Thank you for showing us what love truly means, what it truly means to love. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angry.
Thank you for showing us that love never fails and how trials and tribulations can be overcome. We love you. Happy 50th anniversary.
Thank you.
You got it.
Don't embarrass my dad and my
First of all, I wanna say it's a pleasure to be here to witness 50 years of my aunt and my uncle's anniversary. I just wanna thank you and Auntie for all the years and all the time that you took up with us, man. It really mean a lot to us. You know, having you as uncle is a blessing. Even though, you know, we go at it from time to time. I call you sometimes, get on your nerve, but that's what I do. You know, it goes back to us going, you used to take us downtown to New York Charter to get our haircuts. You was like a father to us. And oh man, it means so much to us, man. And to be here, Monica called me about a month ago and asked me to come home and, you know, say a few words. I don't mind running up and down the road. I said, man, let me come on down here and say something for my uncle and my beautiful auntie. Now, this go back further than 50 years ago. I heard stories about how y'all walk up and down the hallway at Wilson. You know, a lot of people admire you, huh? A lot of people admire you. A lot of people look up to you, man. And me, PJ, and Apple, you know we really look up to you. You know, and I love you, man. And I wish y'all plenty more years. Y'all just take it easy, man.
We are not crying tonight, my friends. No tears. Next, we have Mr. and Mrs. Cornelius Eccles.
But growing up, I said, that man get on my nerves, man, sometimes. But I know I thank God for having you in my life. I love you. I wish I could love you 50 more years if we see 50 more years. You two aren't, and I'm very proud of y'all. Oh, one more thing. Say the man that find a woman's find a good thing. Why you ain't taught me this?
She out there, Jerry. She out there. Mr. Thomas Marks. Y'all clap for PJ, y'all.
And a child. First of all, hey family, how y'all doing? Uncle T, y'all know Pete all love y'all. Y'all a big inspiration to me. I never put y'all out. Anytime y'all call me to come do anything, I do it. I love mom and daddy. Maggie, you know, yeah. You know where I came from, yeah. Mom and daddy. Man, everybody that said about what I wanted to say to y'all, man. I got more water in me right now than the Atlantic and the Pacific Ocean. Water come out of me. Know what I'm saying? Where he at? Where them girls say earlier? Y'all husbands, whoever. Y'all lucky. Oh, God, and Kimmy, y'all lucky. Y'all don't know my uncle like we do. Yes, sir. Everybody that said what I wanted to say to y'all, man. Well, I wanted to say, I didn't got to pull my little people out my pocket because they didn't say it at all. I love y'all. Let me come do to y'all one day, I'll be there. I love y'all. God bless y'all.
We have someone who want to say something. Mr. Eric.
Ms. Margaret, Mr. Monroe, known as J-Bo to me. You've been an example in my life, my whole life, ever since I was a little boy. You inspired me to be a owner-operator, truck driver. And you showed black excellence when it came to love. Because you was one of the first black men that I seen with a wife took care of his kids. A lot of us, me and my friends, we didn't have father figures in our life. We had single parent, you know, homes. But I grew up seeing this man take care of his family. And I'm a truck driver now, thanks to you, because you always inspired me. And when I used to see him crank up that big yellow truck, I said, Lord, I want to do that one day. And when I became my age, that's when I did. And I want to thank you. And happy 50th anniversary.
Y'all got to stop now. I said no tears. Okay, we got Mr. Robert want to say something. This whole table right here, I don't know what they got going on, y'all. But they trying to get us to cry.
How you doing, family? Uncle J. Bo, Uncle Margaret, y'all know me all my life, and I want to say thank you. Margaret, you failed us. Clean the yard, sweep the yard, break up something first, and I'll feed you. And you did that. J. Bo, you taught the coolest. I mean, you taught us how to be a man, you taught us how to be cool, you taught us anything that had to do with being a man, you taught us. We look up to you forever. Like we, me, Matt, PJ, we get together, talk about Uncle J-Bo. That's a cool dude, man. Like, we could be like Uncle J-Bo. But I thank y'all for, you know, accepting me for your nephew, and much love to all y'all. Happy 50th anniversary.
Okay, lastly, but certainly not least, Mr. William Davis. Excuse me, Trey Davis.
praises, all praises. Peace, 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 love, light, peace, peace. I'm Trey, again, if you don't know me, that's my wife over there, Kiki.
Hey.
These people obviously are my, you know, my mother and father-in-law. Gosh, where do I start? I guess 21 years ago, when this woman decided she wanted to be my little girlfriend. So from that moment, you know, even from walking her to, I remember walking outside from band practice, I did get a little, he did give me a little, you know, a little leeway because I was on the band. That was the only thing I had going for me. But I remember walking, and I used to never walk all the way to that van. I would stop and do that number right there. I'm not going over there. I knew I was not about to mess with that man by his girl. Like I said, I'm just thankful to be up here. I'm thankful to actually have the opportunity to actually speak about some people that's meant so much to me. Like I said, I'm a real big, my main motto is presence over presence. A lot of people feel like love is what you can buy. A lot of people feel like they can buy your love or pay for things or just say you love them. Love is an action word. And there's certain people that shows it. And these two are two people that show love, and this just goes to prove it, how all these people are here today. Because everybody's here today to show y'all love because y'all have planted those seeds. And those seeds have grown, and as you see, what your fruits have grown. As you see, everybody is here today in honor of y'all because we all see that at the end of the day, it is possible that you can go 50 years with someone and love someone that long, give them their time, your energy, your love, your patience. Goodness gracious, patience. Let my wife, goodness gracious, patience. I don't want to be up here long, I can get long-winded, but like I said, I am so thankful, super appreciative. Mama Margaret always kept me, especially once I had them kids, like, hey, you know what your job is. I never, ever, ever, ever forgot, and she would never allow for me to forget what my job was. And I appreciate that, because now today, I see a 15-year-old boy, see a 9-year-old girl that I'm super proud of just to watch them grow, just to watch them become who they are. And I appreciate y'all spending so much time with them and showing that y'all care, showing that being there, showing your presence. Because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter how many gifts we give each other. If you're not there, if they don't see you, if they're not present, is everything. And I am so grateful that y'all showed y'all presence when it came to my family, when it came to any and everybody. Apparently everybody here obviously felt your presence. And that's why we all here to celebrate y'all. And I can't tell y'all how much I'm thankful and how grateful I am for y'all to be in my life. And I'll be perfectly honest with you, just like all of them say, at the end of the day, when it comes to you pops, at the end of the day, there's no man on God's green earth I'd rather make proud than you. No man. At all. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. I'll do anything on God's green earth for y'all. Anything. And I mean that. And they know at the end of the day, I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. And 50 more, and I'm with it. We can go ahead and keep on rolling. I'm gonna be home.
I apologize. But on Auntie, y'all know she love y'all just as much as I do. I mean, I probably had to stay with y'all tonight if I wouldn't have came back up here, you know, and let y'all know how much my wife loved y'all too. And I must say it again, Uncle Nancy. 50 years. Keep it going.
Thank you, everyone. So now we are are going to prepare for dinner. We're going to have blessing of the food by Mr. Eric Little.
She had to make that announcement. I wanted to grab the mic as soon as Trey got finished and say, let the church say amen. Amen, amen again. Well, I'm going to bless this food, but as quiet and shy as I am, I'm going to say something about this couple here. I'm new to the family, 6 years new, almost. And when I was going through my singleness and praying and asking the Lord to give me a wife that had strong family values, I didn't know he was going to give me the Huxtables part two. I didn't know that, but I'm very, very thankful. I'm very appreciative of the example of you, Mr. Monroe and Miss Margaret, because my parents are no longer with me. My mother died last year, and my father never got a chance to meet you guys, but he would have loved y'all. If y'all can't deal with me, y'all definitely gonna handle him. But I just want to say, man, it's just beautiful to see you guys together, sticking through the thick and thin. It's just an honor for me. Always wanted my child to have a relationship with their grandparents. And though both my parents are gone, I have greatly appreciated being a part of this family. The first time I met you guys, I think at Thanksgiving, I told you I was going to marry your daughter. And y'all was like, we don't even know you. But it's just been a learning experience from the moment I, you know, had my first Christmas with you guys and y'all all was dressed in pajamas and I was like, is this a joke? Do I need to wear pajamas too? You know, it's just been a great experience. And I just wanted to say, you know, I'm praying for that God will allow me and Monica to experience the kind of longevity that you guys have experienced. And I'm just really, really humbled to be a part of you guys' family. So Father, right now we thank you for Miss Margaret and Mr. Monroe. We thank you for what they represent as a couple. We thank you, Father, for what they represent to all of these people that are here. And God, we thank you for what they represent for the generations to come. There will always be a reference point that we will be able to point to. Our children's children will be able to know that in the wake of all of the changes that's happening in the landscape of family, that it is possible. So, Father, let all of us who have been impacted by this family and our families, let us be able to carry the legacy to the next generation. And, Father, I ask you to bless this food. Let it be a nourishment to our bodies. Let nobody get fat from this cake over here and all this other stuff. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, everyone who said beautiful words to my parents. Happy 50th. Before we get started with dinner, I think she need a few more minutes. We're going to call you by table. We're going to feed our beautiful couple first, and then we'll call you up by table. Thank you.
Yeah. Oh, you're back.